Good morning. My name is Anna, and I'm here with Andrea, Anna, and Cindy. And today, we're going to discuss the very delicate topic of domestic violence. Our group question for today is, why is domestic violence a problem in society? To first answer this question, we must understand what domestic violence is. Domestic violence is a violent or aggressive behavior typically involving the family members or the partners of the victim. And domestic violence involves more than just physical harm. It also involves mental, abusive, physical, sexual, and emotional abuse. My question was, what are the signs of domestic violence? Usually, the signs or red flags involve embarrassing you with put-downs, controls what you do, controls who you see, who you talk to, controls everything, makes all the decisions, obviously, threatens to kill him or herself or you if you try to leave the relationship. Now I will pass it off to Cindy.
As we already know, domestic violence has been a problem for a long period of time, and what people don't realize is that children are the most affected in the relationship, which is why I chose my question, how does domestic violence affect children? Here are some ways children and teenagers are affected. Mental abuse, which is behavior that may result in psychological trauma, including anxiety and chronic depression. Physical abuse, which is any intentional act causing injury or trauma to another person, like hitting, slapping, etc. Sexual abuse and lastly, emotional abuse, which involves constant shaming and humiliating. For example, if you're yelling and telling a child that they're worthless, that affects them emotionally. The trauma that children experience when they witness domestic violence in the home plays a major role in their development and physical well-being, because a child is like a sponge and they absorb everything around them, and when they see something they know is wrong, they tend to want to get away from it, and they begin to fear or they learn from it and become more abusive than the person they learn from. I'll be showing you guys a video of a child who witnesses domestic violence in his home.
Daddy!
Hey, mate, how are ya? Good to see ya. Have you been a good boy for Mummy?
Yes, Dad.
How was your Rotary Club meeting today?
Crying because his dad was beating the wife up, which is his mom, and he obviously didn't want that to happen. And there was a quote at the end saying, what's on the outside isn't always on the inside. Like, from what I understood from it is that, like, in a relationship, we don't always, like, outside, like, we don't always see what's going on, but on the inside, they're, like, feeling, like, emotionally depressed or something like that.
Given this topic, I asked myself, why does a victim stay after being abused? At first, I said to myself, there is no answer to justify this question. But as I did my research, I began to look up some ways why a person must stay in a relationship. It is believed that the person might stay in a relationship because they have a fear that whenever they might go outside, that they might have, they might be scared that their partner might, like, come home to them and they might start abusing them. Stockholm Syndrome is when you feel like you're being, you're betraying your abuser if you go to an authority. It can happen when you have been held hostage for a while and begin to have a connection with your abuser. A financial issue is why many others stay, because they only depend and rely on their partner for money and for their child. Some religious people might stay also because since it's said in the Bible that God does not believe in divorce, but it's also said that God doesn't believe in abuse. Having children involved in a relationship will also keep one of the parents to keep from having a divorce, to give a child a perfect family illusion. As you've seen in the video, you can tell by the way that this is not the first time that it happened before. It has happened many times, but the mom has stayed in the relationship just to give their child a perfect family illusion. I can list a million reasons why a person must stay in a relationship, but there is no answer to justify why to stay in a relationship.
So about 85% out of 100 women are being abused, and only about 15% men have been victims of domestic violence as well. The reason why you don't really hear men being abused is because they really don't like talking about it because they're embarrassed and ashamed of it. So my question was how to prevent domestic violence. Well, I picked this question because there isn't really a way to stop it, but there's a way to prevent it. Like, there should be programs that they can go to, and just like their family helping them out with support and with their education since they're small, and like the things they learn from their parents. So, so domestic violence is common, but if you really take note into it, you may see like the little details and suspect something abusive, because the person being abused may not say anything because they may be too scared or still want to stay with that person because they really love them or just want to stay with them for support. And if they are just too scared, you need to have a voice for them and speak up to them. And these are our sources.
Jay, you started this, so let's start with you for our questions. How are your findings at the end of all this research different than what you thought you would find out when you started the research?
At first, I thought it was going to be, you know, all the information that maybe like our parents have told us mm-hmm. when we're growing up, but then going deeper into it, it's actually, there's way more to it than just, you know, learning how to stay away from, you know, people who cause toxic or negative energy to your life. From this, I found out why most people stay in the relationship. And most people will think, well, why don't you just leave? It's not that easy for them to just leave. They're living in constant fear. And that is something that I thought was very, very surprising and very scary to look like that.
Okay. All right. And Cindy?
Yeah.
Why did you include the video? Why did you think it was important for us to watch the video?
So you guys to see like an example of a child, like how it would affect them. Child at the end of the video was crying because he saw his mom getting beat up.
Okay. And Andrea, Of all of the information that all of you guys found, which do you think was the most important for us to take away from this presentation? Like, what do you want everybody to, and it can be your information or anybody in the group's information. What's the message we should take away from your presentation? If we remember anything from this, what should we remember?
To catch the signs earlier on, we should the red flags.
Okay, so that very first stuff that Anna was talking about. Okay. All right, and Anna Q. What was something that you guys decided to leave out of this presentation? Was there any information that you were like, that's interesting, but it doesn't work for us?
No, we kept everything.
Yeah, that was all just really important. Yeah. Nothing got lost. Okay, all right. Thank you so much.